Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. In today's video, we are going to be making large knotless braid on this hair. As you can see here, I've already straightened her hair with hot comb. I've done that already, but not so well. I did that a little bit so I can be able to part her hair because her hair was really tangled. So guys, please, if today is your first time of stopping by, you are highly welcome. Just remember to click the subscribe button if you haven't done so, and thank you as you do that. So now I'll go ahead and part her hair into the sizes I will be braiding. One secret I will tell you about how to make a large knotless braid is that, as you can see, once I part the hair, I will apply shine and jam at the root. And after applying the shine and jam at the root, I will fold the hair and leave it. Then I will go and section another portion of hair. And once that is done, I will fold that portion again and leave it. The reason why I'm applying shine and jam, fold it and leave it, is because by the time I would have finished parting all the hair and come back, the shine and jam I applied might have dried a little bit, making the root of the hair not to be so slippery while braiding the hair, as in making the root to be firm. Okay, that's why I prefer to apply the shine and jam at the root some minutes before braiding the hair. I don't know if that makes sense, because sometimes after applying the shine and jam and you braid immediately, you'll find out that the hair will be slippery. So that's the major reason why, as I part the hair, I will apply shine and jam and fold it. By the time I will come back to start braiding, the hair would have dried a little bit, thereby not being slippery as I'll be gripping the root. Okay, that's the major reason why I do this. So guys, that is it. I'm done doing that. Now I'll go ahead and show you guys how you can actually braid large knotless braid. I will use this hot comb to straighten her hair more so that I'll be able to tuck in the hair into the hair extension. Her hair is really tangled and frizzy, so I will straighten the hair with this electric comb before I start braiding. As you all can see, the root of her hair now is a kind of fame. Is a kind of firm and not slippery because the shine and jam I applied there has already dried a little bit. So now I'll start by adding a bit large hair extension. Because I am making a large knotless braid, the extension I will start with will be a little bit big. As I move, I will be decreasing, I will be reducing the hair extension I add. But if you are making small knotless braid, you will always start with a small hair extension. Okay, so because I'm making big one, I started with big hair extension. Alright, so that's it guys, that's it. So once I flip the hair over, I will now start to tuck in her natural hair. As you tuck in the natural hair and you feel like it's not really slipping into the hair extension, you can apply shine and jam to it. I'm doing that now. You apply shine and jam to the natural hair. That will make it easy for you to hide it into the natural hair. Into the hair extension, I meant to say. Then you continue braiding. So now I'll go ahead and also braid this one so you guys will see how I do that once again. I will divide the hair into three. Then, as you can see, as you divide the hair into three, make sure you grab all the natural hair. Then start by adding large, not like big large, like add a bigger portion of, start with a bigger portion of hair extension. As you move, you keep on reducing the hair extension, okay? If you really want your knotless braid to be nice, where you have to make sure that you do a good job is while gripping the hair. You have to make sure that you grip all the hair and you grip them so tight, so that after braiding, the root will not be loose or the hair extension will not be folding over. Like if you're making small knotless braid and you start with a bigger hair extension, definitely after braiding that hair, the hair will fold over. It will not be straight, it will fold over. So I am using large hair extension to start this one because I am making large knotless braid. I don't know if you guys understand this, but that's just it. If you're making a large knotless braid, you have to start with a bigger hair extension. But if you're making a small knotless braid, you have to start with a small hair extension. You have to start adding small hair extension, okay? So now I'll go ahead and braid the rest of the hair. And as I'll be braiding it, I'll try to hide her natural hair. This hair, I will not braid it all the way to the end because I'll be coiling the tip of the hair. So I'll braid it to some point, then I will knot it because I'll be coiling the tip. So now I'm done braiding the hair, guys, and this is how it looks like. Did you see? We are done braiding the hair. So the next thing I will do here is I'll go ahead and coil the tip of the hair using a coiler. So now I'm done coiling the tip of the hair. The next thing to do is I'll go ahead and apply hot water to it. So now I'm done applying hot water to it. I'll go ahead and remove the coiler. So after removing the coiler, the hair is ready. So guys, if you enjoyed watching this video, kindly give us a thumbs up, subscribe to our YouTube channel if you haven't done so. Also, comment and share this video. Thank you all for always coming back. Thank you all for always clicking on the video. Thank you. I will see you all in my next video. Bye.